Hi, this is Jessica with the Physicians Committee, and today is National STEM Day, a day to celebrate the value of education and careers in STEM, that is, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So of course, here at the Physicians Committee, we would like to celebrate by sharing six important technologies that are moving us away from using animals in science. The first technology that I want to celebrate is recombinant protein production. Recombinant proteins are produced by copying the gene of the protein you want, like the gene for human insulin, and then growing that protein in cells in a lab. This is a huge win for people and animals. Years ago, insulin for diabetics came from the pancreas of pigs and cows. With recombinant insulin, we can give patients real human insulin that is safer and less variable than animal insulin. The second technology is in silico, or computational toxicology. In silico is a fancy Latin phrase for using computers to run experiments for you. This is a hot field in toxicology because we can organize and share decades of data on thousands of chemicals as a free download or even a web browser program that can perform experiments at the click of a button. Of course, we still need ways to study diseases, drugs, and other chemicals in the lab, so that's why we use in vitro cell culture. In vitro is another fancy Latin phrase, and it means in glass. So for human research, we use it to talk about growing human cells in a dish or in lots of little dishes. There are so many ways to study human biology using cells, either directly from donors or stored in biobanks. Donor cells and tissues are precious to researchers because they represent the most important benchmark for understanding human health. Our next technology that you may have heard of is big data, or what we like to call the Age of Omics. Now, when we say omics, we're referring to our ability to record with impressive accuracy all the genes or all the proteins in a person's cells, or in cells that have been cultured in a dish. This allows us to understand the differences between health and disease, the differences between how two patients might respond to the same treatment, and how different chemicals and materials impact human tissues. And something we can use that big data for is understanding how to design tools in a lab that accurately reflect what happens in a human being. Organ on a chip is a functioning organ system that allows us to study diseases and effects of drugs and other chemicals. These organ chip systems can actually be made very complex, and when they are connected, they can allow us to study, for instance, how the metabolism of a drug in the gut affects toxicity of that drug in the heart. We know that drugs developed in animal tests often fail to show safety in humans because animals don't have human biology. So organ chips can help us understand what will actually happen in humans before we offer a drug or use a pesticide on food. And finally, we can't talk about technology without talking about artificial intelligence and machine learning. One of the most important principles in studying biology, or medicine, or toxicology is the ability to model what will happen in a person. With all of the big data we can generate from so many experimental systems, from donor cells in vitro or tissue and organ models cultured in a lab, we are creating more data than we can humanly process. But machine learning and artificial intelligence can help us with that workload. It still takes humans to curate the data and design testable hypotheses, but we can let computers take the lead in finding the patterns and hallmarks of diseases or toxic exposures. So there you have it. As you celebrate STEM Day today, we hope you are celebrating how technological innovators are bringing us out of the dark ages of animal testing and into the 21st century. If you'd like to find out how you can help facilitate a transition from animal use to human relevant methods, visit pcrm.org/ethical science.